Hi, it's Anna Mason, and in this mini class, I'm going to show you how I created the shine to this glossy tomato using watercolor. Let's take a look at the process. Having lightly drawn my tomato, I began painting by mapping out the lightest tones or values in each color area using a watery wash. Even though I'd be painting over the top of this layer, I always apply the paint in the direction of form as it helps to create a 3D look. Once that had dried, I applied another layer of watery paint to everywhere except those very lightest areas to isolate the highlights and make sure I wouldn't paint over them later as they would become the reflections on the shiny tomato. Next, making sure as always that my paper was totally dry, I went all the way to the other end of the tonal range and painted the very darkest tones on the tomato, where the shadows are. I used a brownish purple mix for this. It looked really disjointed at this point, but it put me in the ideal position to know how dark to take the other areas in the painting. The next stage was to take a step along the tonal range and paint the next darkest areas, which were a rich, dark red colour. With those dried off, I went along the tonal range again to paint the mid-mid tones, which were about halfway between the very lightest and the very darkest tones in the tomato. I used a vibrant red colour for these and applied it to any areas that would end up this hue and tone or darker. When I was applying this mix close to the green parts, I used the tip of my brush and made sure to leave some small gaps through to the lighter colour underneath to help create the appearance of the tiny hairs covering the greenery. Then I united the lightest tones and midtones by painting in the lighter midtones. I applied this mix to the areas that have a more orangey hue, and then the areas with more of a grey hue. The tomato was looking really 3D by this point, so I could now see which areas needed some darkening. So I spent time making tonal adjustments and working into the transitions between lighter and darker areas. I relaxed into a flow light state as I tuned into all the small shapes of colour and tone. I was now ready to work on the green parts called the pedicel and sepals. So I cleaned my brush and palette and refreshed my water so as not to mix any red into the green by accident. Having already painted the lightest tones of green, I went straight in now with the darkest tones, and then painted the darker midtones using a stippling technique on those green parts to recreate the hairy appearance. With that dry, I applied the lighter midtones using a brighter green mix, and then made a round of adjustments to the greenery wherever I could see that I needed to darken. Next came my favourite part of the painting process, final adjustments. It's this stage that you can really ramp up the realism. I compared my painting with my reference photo, darkening and brightening my painting wherever I could see differences. Only once I was completely satisfied that the areas around them were dark enough, could I at last come in with my smallest brush and some white gouache to paint some extra little hair details to the green parts. I went back one last time to the transitions around the highlights to smooth them and make sure they looked right. And then my glossy tomato painting was finished. A full video class of this tomato is available now in my online school. If you've enjoyed this mini class, please subscribe to my YouTube channel, then pop over to annamasonart.com where you can take a full-length video class for free and find a whole heap of resources to help you pick up your brush and paint the way you've always wanted to. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you soon to help you create watercolours with WOW.
Tomato, 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 let's pull the whole thing off.